Hi, it's Kiffin Lebates here, and this is kind of a continuation of yesterday's video where I was talking about front running in decentralized finance and on Ethereum. And I thought today I would look at a particular exploit that I think is really rather clever and gives you some insight into the complexities of what's going on in this space. So this technique is called sandwiching. And yesterday I was talking about front running, which is where you duplicate a profitable transaction, and then by paying extra gas or by being a miner, you front run the trade. You execute first and therefore get the profit, and the legitimate trade comes second and loses out. And it has parallels in conventional finance. So the exploit that I wanted to talk about today is called sandwiching, and it applies to automated market makers like Uniswap. And it exploits a particular feature of AMMs, which is that for every swap that takes place on an AMM like Uniswap, the price of the token being swapped shifts slightly. And that's how automated market makers work. If there's, you have a token, tree token, right? If people start buying tree tokens with ether, then the ether price of tree tokens goes up. And similarly, if people start selling tree tokens in order to get ether back using the AMM, then the price of tree tokens in ether drops. So what the sandwiching technique does is it notices that someone has placed an order to, say, buy tree tokens. And what the attacker then does is they create two transactions, one that takes place just before the tree token purchasing transaction and one that takes place immediately after it. And the preceding transaction, what they do is they buy a lot of tree tokens, and that pushes the price up in the automated market maker. Now the legitimate transaction takes place, but instead of getting the number of tree tokens that they were expecting, they get a lot less because the price has gone up. And then immediately after their purchase goes through, where they've ended up buying these tokens at an inflated price, the second transaction kicks in where the bot basically sells off all the tree tokens that they bought in the first place, thereby pushing the price back down. And the effect that this has is that a percentage of the ether that was spent on buying tree tokens by the legitimate trade is siphoned off to the bot. It's quite clever, really, and must also be quite disappointing for people who get hit by it. So there's an example of the kind of exploits that are currently taking place in decentralized finance. And I tell you something, it really makes me wonder at the ingenuity of human beings. When there's a profit to be made, it really seems to kick people into a higher gear in order to see how they can get hold of some. I mean, I don't think I would have thought of that exploit myself. But I guess my mind doesn't work in that way. Anyway, so there you go, an example of a decentralized finance exploit that's like front running, but slightly more complicated and generally speaking, quite lucrative. I hope you found that interesting and that it gives you an idea of the kind of things that are going on in decentralized finance. And I'll see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.